This next bout of the evening is sponsored by DNA Training and takes place at a catch weight of 63 kilos. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, representing SBG Charlestown, Carl McConaway! Introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, representing Team KF, Shane
Dawes. The crew is gorgeous. Walk down cash from the circus. Yeah. We'll never ever make them earn it. They ain't about to do it. Yeah. Like a chip and a salsa. I guarantee that I'll flog your soul for seeing you running for cover. Been holding out now. It's like they see you on the way to the woods. Take one, one, four. Take one, Katie Jan and my foot. Make sure we came to a struggle. We talk to them, we do. I see you've been about the hustle. When it's time to work, we're gonna fuck it. So who's going next? Can you ever try and get pressed? We gave better, we boring. He can't collect the checks. Man, put up in Lurgis. On my G-spin phone, fuck me. I'm gonna have to pay the service. I'm gonna be from the
Conway in the red, Shane in the grey shorts. McConway seems to be fighting on every single show we go to, Andrew.
Ever in existence. He's had a very busy 2022.
Yeah, he was on the last of the year and he's fought twice since. And I think he's fighting again possibly next week, but just relentless, high-pressure fighter. Lost a hard-fought decision at the last UR3 against Darren O'Brien.
After one of the best fights of the night.
It was a blood fest, wasn't it? In the third round, he came back with just chasing that fight in the third round and did a lot of damage. And the same then on Cage Legacy shortly after against Ross Querney, a great three-round war. Loves a scrap. And he's in on a double leg takedown here.
Back to full guard here for Shane Dunne.
Shane, of course, only has one fight so far, so there's a bit of an experience differential here, although...
Yeah, definitely, but...
Comes some good stock with Team KF, and none of their guys ever look out of their depth in these cages.
No, and I am guessing that he comes from a form of striking background. Watch him when he whips this right hand. He brings it back into a very, very active position straight away.
And a lovely left hook. Very accurate. He did have one MMA fight back in 2019, so it's been a while.
He's been encouraged to go for his shots from Chris Fields here.
His head was very high there and he ate one in that exchange. Conway, of course, leans heavily on his wrestling in a lot of his bouts, and he's a jiu-jitsu purple belt too. And his grinding grappling style. Landed shots of his own, McConway, in the stand-up exchanges here.
Yeah, Both big lads for 61 kg. Very big lads.
I think this one's at a catch weight of 63, but they both generally fight at 61.
Thank you for correcting my error, Paul. I appreciate it.
Scribbled out and replaced on my card. It could be a misprint. Which I have both bad rights. Conway in on the legs, transition beautifully to the legs. Is his neck in danger here? He looks okay, he looks comfortable, yeah. Heavy shots on the ground on the way up, and probably lovely knees to the hamstring. A good first round in the books.
Shane seems to have a lot of support just sitting directly behind us. But
it's a good team KF crew here today.
Yeah, I have to say, Carl looked solid in that round. He was landing a lot of good strikes. He was keeping his head off the centre line. He was trying to get in and use the strikes to start a grappling exchange. But Shane does seem to be the crisper striker.
Yeah, it's been an interesting
and landed a lot of nice ones of his own, so...
Shaping up nicely to be another Carl McConway three-round war.
Exciting fight, yeah, absolutely.
One in the books so far, very impressive first round. McConway confidently to the centre of the cage to begin round two, and like you said, Andrew, moving the head well and looking to create those openings. Catches the kick, returns with a right hand beautifully.
Yeah, you can definitely see not necessarily the ability difference, but definitely the experience difference between the two of them. Carl is constantly moving his hands, he's using feints. Chris is currently asking Shane to give him more in terms of the feints to set up his strikes. Carl's nearly able to get an early read on them if he's just thrown flat.
Very experienced McConway. He's won belts on a lot of promotions, at least three or four other promotions, and fought some of the best names in amateur mixed martial arts at this weight class. Chasing a three-fight win streak since that last outing here on Euro 3. Double again. Gets done down to the floor. Has good posture in that position, so the guillotine doesn't seem to be threatening.
Yeah, no, McConway is actually using his other arm there very well to stop and connect and palm to palm.
Yeah, just experience shining through a little bit in that transition. You see Dunn now thinking about that Kimura grip, but it wasn't really there. Conway just keeping a heavy low base and not allowing the space. Chasing the back. Grinding heavily on Shane Dunn at the moment. Look at that Dagestani handcuff behind the back. Conway creates the separation. Eats a left hook, a right hook on the way out. Transitions into the takedown attempt.
4 seconds left. Carl McConway was aggressive there and looking for the back.
Yeah, he seems to just have a chin on him, doesn't he? Eats shots and like they never happened in all of his bouts. And trying to smother Shane Dunn on the floor and improve his position. Looking for that back mount.
Carl's body lock. Relentless here in the last 15 seconds. Just trying to go and chain that position to position.
Go, excellent second round again from McConway, albeit he did get dropped once in that round. And it wouldn't be a Karen McConway fight without him getting dropped at least once.
Yeah, he seemed to be moving in quite fast as the shot landed on him. He was able to then close the distance. Shane wasn't able to step back out to be able to keep his shots going. Chris Fields asked his coach, or asked his fighter there, to look at him as he was walking across to the other side there. He seems to think that Carl might be more tired than we do.
I don't think I've ever seen Carl Conway tired in a bout.
But he's very good at hiding it if he is.
The longer the fight goes, the more he seems to relish it in these wars. Conway barely breathing heavily at all, in fact. It's been a very assured performance for the most part of the war. Dawn looking to pick his shots here and find that chin of McConway, trying to create openings. An uppercut. Seen Dunn become a little more confident in these exchanges, dishing out some feints, landing a nice 1-2, shoots in on McConway on a double attempt. I think we're seeing a physical strength advantage here for McConway.
Yeah, definitely. He had that hands connected on the back of the hamstring, and whatever way Carl reacted or postured up, the hands just slid up onto his lower back as he was trying to scoop him out to get the takedown in front of his corner.
Yeah, a bit more miles on the clock, a bit more savvy. Body is just conditioned to these wars. Lovely trip by Shane Dunn. Beautiful work.
Step-by-step instructions as well towards it. The back exposed for a second.
What a reverse.
Is there a guillotine on? The head's going to pop out, I think. He's disconnected the hands. Wow. Carl McConway just looked at us. Not that that's a big thing in itself, but he was looking right at us there.
He looks so comfortable in these
he
does.
Outs,
doesn't he? Hasn't taken any damage so far. Looks to be relishing in this three-round battle with Shane Dunn. Lovely lacing through with that left arm. Takes that arm with both hands. Uses it to take a post from under his opponent and slide a hook in on that left side. Beautiful work by McConway. And there's the right hook. Excellent transition to the back. That was beautiful, that two-on-one grip. Maintains that top position now in the scramble. Landing some shots now.
Yeah, he still has that grip. Yeah, still has the grip on the wrist the whole way through.
There's the back take again.
This could be under.
And there's the tap. Beautiful work from Carl McConway. Absolutely dominant performance in round three.
Lovely transitional grappling there for Carl to get the finish. He was very consistent in looking for his chains. He had one hook initially. He lost it through the second hook in. Worked very diligently towards getting the back. It seemed like it was going to not go his way at the very end in terms of the scramble, but a good recovery for on his end and a nice rear naked choke finish.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Gareth Lyons calls a halt to proceedings after 2 minutes and 22 seconds of round number 3. Your winner by rear naked choke, Carl!